We are going to see fraction, radicals, radicand, index, and third here. And then we will see some problems on simplification of radical expressions and comparison of thirds. In mathematics, a lot of symbols are used, plus sign, minus sign, multiplication, division. Each symbol is for a purpose. You all know this purpose. Similarly, for a particular purpose, radical symbol is used. The radical symbol is here. You can see here. Okay, I'm using this symbol. And the number or variable inside the radical is called radicand. I'll show it to you a little later. Root of 5, 5 is the radicand here. Okay. And we'll see the square roots. First of all, we'll take the numerical numbers. 1, square root of 1 is 1, square root of 4 is 2. Square root of 9 is 3, like that, you know, up to 64. Square root of 64 is 8. 8 into 8 is 64, therefore 64 square root is 8. Similarly, for the variable also we can see. If you see the pattern here, the square should be have an exponent of even number. See 2, 4, 6, 8, 12, 14. Then only the root is 14 by 2, 12 by 2, 8 by 2. If it is odd number, it won't be a root, right? Therefore, the condition is exponent should be even number to get the root of the radical, right? Okay. Now, fraction. You see 4 by 8, you can have a common factor 4 here. Therefore, 4 ones are 4, 4 twos are 8. Therefore, the simplified fraction is 1 by 2. In the same way, we can also have simplified radical expression. For that, what we do is we have to have factors, you know, the radicals. We must have factors. What is a factor? We will see. 12 is equal to 4 into 3. So 4 and 3 go into 12. Therefore, 4 and 3 are factors here. Right? Then we will see radical. Radical is a symbol here. Please note, we are sometimes saying square root or root, but radical. This is called radical. The term under the radical symbol is called radicand. We will see here now. The radicand can be either number or a variable. See, 24 is a number here. And you can see here, x power 4 is a variable here. This is the radicand. This is the radicand. 3 is called index. The number above the V in the radical symbol is called index. So 3 is index. 3 is the index here. An expression with the radical symbol is called third. We can simplify the radical expression, that is thirds. We will see here. X power 2n. Root of x power 2n. This is a third because it has got a root x power n. Similarly, this also is 3 cube is answer here. Here 6 is answer. Here this is a simplified radical expression because 55 has no factor, right, of perfect square. 55, 5 into 11 is 55, but 5 is prime, 11 is prime, therefore it has no factors. Similarly, 5 into 2, 5 is prime, 2 is prime, therefore 10 has no perfect square as factor. Simplified radical expressions. Procedure we will see here. What is a radical? It is in its simplest form. If the radicand has no factors as perfect square. So cube root of x cube. Root of x cube is not in its simplest form because x cube is x squared into x. So root of x squared, it is called a perfect square. Therefore x is the answer for this. So root x is the garbage, I will say. X into root x is the answer. This is a simplified radical form. This is third. We will see product rule, which is very, very important. We will be using it in simplifications. Root of AB is equal to root of A into root of B. For example, root of 12 is equal to root of 4 into 3, which is nothing but root of 4 into root of 2. Root of 4 is 2, so 2 root 2 is the answer. So, like that, 36 is perfect square, 6 into 6. Garbage is nil, therefore answer is root only, that is 6. Root of 10 is the simplest form because root 5 into root 2 are non-factorable. Similarly, root 55 is also radical in its simplest form. Some problem and procedures we will see. First of all, we have to factorize the radicand. Here we have factorized 36, right? Here also factorize 5 into 2. Then apply the product rule to get the largest perfect square, thus go into it. And the garbage left over. Largest perfect square for this is 6 to 6, 36. Find the roots and find the garbage, the root and the garbage together gives the answer. All right. For example, 72, the largest perfect square is 36. If you divide by 2, you will get it. Root of 36 into 2, which is nothing but root of 36 into root of 2. 6 into root 2 is the answer, simplified form. Similarly, root of x cube is root of x squared into x, which is root of x squared is x. Root x is garbage. X into root x is answer. Root of 128, we will see here. The largest perfect square is 64. If you divide by 2, you will get 64. 64 is nothing but 8 squared. Then what is the step 2? You apply product rule. So the answer is 8 into root 2. Root of 8 squared is 8. Root 2 is the garbage. Keep it. And the answer is root 2. 8 root 2. X power 7. The largest perfect square is 8 x power 6. 1 less than this because this is odd number. So apply the product rule now here. X power 6 into x. So this is x cube. Answer root for this is x cube and this is garbage. So answer is x cube root x. Similarly, a power 21 is some number. So a power 20 is the largest perfect square. The root is a power 10. So answer is a power 10 into root a. Understand? It's a complex problem, but don't be afraid. The method is same. First of all, 50 is split into garbage and largest perfect square. Divide by 2, you get 25 into 2. X cube, x squared into x. X squared is the perfect square. A power 6 is as it is, a power 6 only we can keep it. Or a cube and a cube I have written. V is as it is. Right. Okay. Then what we do is take the perfect square. Root 5 is the root here. This is root of 2. This is answer is x. This is root of x. This a cube is the root and root b is the garbage here. That's the thing. Therefore, the answer is 50, root of 50 x cube a power 6 b is 5 into x into a cube. All the coefficients I'm bringing it together, all the radicands I'm bringing it together by product rule. Root of 2 x b is root 2, root x, root b. The other way. That's all. Root of 2 into root of x into root of b is equal to root of 2 x b. Therefore, answer is there. This is another problem where a coefficient is added. When a coefficient is added, what you have to do is you have to bring the coefficient till the end. At the end, you have to multiply by 2 and then answer will be 10 a cube. See here, 10 x a cube into root of 2 x b. Okay. So, this the coefficient should not be forgotten, should be brought till the end and then multiply with the coefficients of the answer. We will see here comparison of sorts. Here, the most important thing is the order, that is the power, that is the exponent should be same. Now, here, fourth root, here also fourth root. So, we have to compare the radicands and obtain the results. 2 is less than 5. Therefore, fourth root of 2 is less than fourth root of 5. Directly, you can give. Anyway, I will give you the method here. Fourth root of 2 is 2 power 1 by 4. Fourth root of 5 is 5 power 1 by 4. 1 by 4 is same, that is, order is same. Therefore, 2 and 5 compare, radicands you compare. 5 is greater than 2. Therefore, 4th root of 5 is greater than 4th root of 2. Right? Here, greater than 2. Here, 4th root of 2 is less than 4th root of 5. Now, here we will see here, comparison of sorts. 4th root of 5 and cube root of 4. So, here 4th root and here it is 3rd root. See, exponents are not same. Order is not same. So, modify the terms to get the same order. Compare the radicands, obtain the results. After modifying the terms, that is, see to it that the order is same, then only you can compare the radicands and obtain the result. 4th root of 5 is 5 power 1 by 4, cube root of 4 is 4 power 1 by 3. So you take the denominators 4 and 3, LCM is 12, therefore bring the denominator to become 12. 5 power 1 by 4 is 5 power 3 by 12 because multiply 3 by 3, here multiply by 4 by 4, you will get 4 by 12 here. So 5 power 3 by 12 is 5 power 3 into 1 power to the power of 1 by 12. And here you will get 4 power 4 by 12 is equal to 4 power 4 to the power of 1 by 12. Okay. So 1 by 12, 1 by 12 is common, same. Therefore, we can compare 5 cube and 4 power 4. 5 cube is 125. 4 power 4 is 256. Order is same. 1 by 12, compare the radicands. 5 cube is 125, 4 power 4 is 256. 256 is greater than 125 or 125 is less than 256. Therefore, this is less than this. And this is greater than this. Right? cube root of 4 is greater than 4th root of 5, or 4th root of 5 is less than cube root of 4. Now, whatever we have seen so far is, we have seen what is a fraction, what is the similarity between fraction and radicals. Just like fraction, radical also can be simplified. Radicand is the term inside the radical, and index is the term above the V in the radical. And cert is an expression which can be simplified into a simple radical form. And we have seen the simplification problems as well as comparison of certs problems. And what is that radical is a symbol, a number variable inside the radical is called radicand. And what is index also we have seen. That completes the problem. I hope you have understood. I will stop with that. Thank you very much.